Hey everybody, welcome to the hot seat. I'm CJ of Cooking with CJ fame. Tonight we have a special guest. Actually, all my guests are special, but we got another special guest. All right, we got Mike from the Culinary Cookhouse. He's in the house. He's ready to do the dang thing. He's got Christmas galore behind him, just like myself. I'm excited for that. I'm glad to get you on here finally, brother. You know, we've been chatting for a long time. I'm glad you're here. Before we get really going on this, I want to say hi to my co-host with the most, Kent. How you doing, brother?
Good, good. How are you tonight?
I'm fabulous.
Mike, I'm looking forward to this, buddy.
Yeah, me too, guys.
Right on, right on. All right, I'm going to shout out the mods in the chat. I see Leprechaun TV, Jay's here, Scotty from In From The Grill. Let's see here. I think I saw Hobo, but he said he's having some interweb problems, so he's only listening in. And Dan from Smoky Goodness. I haven't seen Red or Kirby, and Miss Booger's not here yet. So welcome, everybody, all my mods. You guys keep them going in the chat. Keep people in line. Shout-outs to the peoples in the chat. We got Mega Fred Zeppelin's in the house. He's here early. He's ready to do the dang thing. We got Keith Bettag keeping score for me. How you doing, big guy? Appreciate it. Jason from Easy Bake Barbecue. Black Hole Barbecue, new subscriber here. What up, homie? All right, what's up, man? Welcome, brother. Good to see you. I've seen you out in the chats before with Leprechaun Jay. See, you got Chris from Eastwood Farms. The Garage Grillers there. Pickles is hitting the house. Christie's Cooking Channel. I see Bottle Cat Barbecue. I see John from 1984 Barbecue. I think that's all. Cooking with Corey just showed up. How you doing, Corey? All right. So that kind of – Cookout Coach. I saw Steve in there too. So that kind of catches us up to right now. I'll shout out other people as we get there, okay? All the Chris's are here. That's right, Bottle Cat. All right, cool. Mike, how you doing, brother?
Doing great, man. There was a little bit of buffering there, but really happy to be on the show with you guys. Love what you've done, the community you've built, and I'm super excited to spend some time with you guys tonight. So thanks for the invite. Appreciate it.
Right on, man. I'm glad you're here, too. So far, my favorite person in the chat today is Keith Bettag, and he just said, I officially won the grilled cheese collaboration, so... He is my hero tonight. I love it. Thanks a lot, Keith. That was very kind of you, my brother. See, Tom's Tinkering Adventures is here. Yoakum294, which is Adam. How you doing, Adam? Good to see you guys here. Corey disagrees with Keith Bettag's assessment. Corey, you don't count, so it's all right. Smoking Joe's Pit Barbecue's in the house. So that's Joe 2. Big Joe? That's Big Joe. BG Barbecue. How you doing, brother? Mel Simple Meals, future guest on the hot seat. Welcome, Mel. How you doing? All right, guys. Before we go on to Mike and all our hard-hitting questions, I just want to say thank you guys for all the super chats last week. The camera fund is going well, so I appreciate you guys all jumping in. Never expected, but always appreciate it. But that's very cool, you guys. Someday we'll get that camera fund going. And we just lost our guest.
I'm right here, guys. I'll be right there.
Hey, Big Lou, how you doing, brother? Good to see you. Good to see you in there. Ray Guy, I saw you too. I think that's it. All right, Mike, are you ready? You got your cocktail in hand. Cheers to you, brother. Cheers to you, Kent. Everybody in the chat. Oh, hey, Roundhouse is here. How you doing? And Jim, Suburban Barbecue. All right, guys. I can't keep shouting out everybody. We'll go back to the chat in a bit. Mikey, where are you from, brother?
Yeah, so I'm from I was born in a suburb of Cleveland, just about 2 miles from where I live now. But I've pretty much born and raised in Cleveland, Ohio, my whole life.
Oh, wow. Right on.
TLE.
Is that okay? So let's just kind of jump into that one real quick. When you started, your name was your channel name was CLE Random, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. What was that and then what prompted the change to the Culinary Cookhouse?
Yeah, so when I started this channel, I had zero intentions of making videos. I just had to come up with a channel name. But being from Cleveland, and I'm just about a mile from Cleveland Hopkins Airport, and their symbol is CLE. Right. So it was just CLE, random, you know, just because I had to make something up. But then I started making the videos. I did some DIY videos that are really successful, but not something that's sustainable for making videos. Like, it's really hard to do a DIY project every weekend and pump out a video, right?
Right.
So I thought maybe I'll do cooking again. I had a cooking channel a long time ago. And so I started making those videos, but nobody knew what my channel was about. So, you know, you're in a live chat or something, CLE random, nobody knows anything about you. So I made the change. Hopefully I'll stick with this name. I like it. It's kind of catchy. And that's kind of that little backstory there.
Right on. I agree with you about it being catchy. I think it's a lot better cooking show name than CLE random. So that works out for you.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, we got more friends in the chat. Dave's from Dave's Ohio Barbecue More. Grill Top Experience. What's New Barbecue? Hey Casey, how you doing? Rob D's in the house, big Rob D. Bill from Chicken Fried Barbecue, which is my favorite name for a channel so far. I love it. All right. All right, I see Mega Fred is in there, and I want to get his question asked before he needs to go to sleep. So talk about your favorite music, your favorite bands, instruments you play, anything like that.
Yeah, I'm really all over the board. It depends on the occasion. So I do a lot of travel, and if I'm driving through the cornfields of Ohio and Michigan, I might have on some Joe Satriani or Buckethead. If I'm at home out in the garage and I got Donna and Sherry and the friends over, I might have on like, Pandora, Prince. So some 80s music, that's fun. but you know, I'm all over the place. The last concert I went to, was Rammstein. So I get into some of the heavier stuff too. I love music. There's not a whole lot I don't like. I like a lot of the old country, Waylon Jennings, Johnny Cash, Hank Williams Jr. I love older rap, so West Side Connection for you guys out there in California. Some Ice Cube. I still think Ice Cube is the best I've ever heard. Dr. Dre, all those guys. But you never know. It just depends on what mood I'm in.
Right on, right on. And I'm still waiting for someone to say Justin Timberlake. I don't know why I know I can just do that. So, very cool. Very cool. That's an eclectic mix, man. You go from Waylon Jennings to Rammstein. Dude, that's a jump right there, brother.
Yeah.
All right. So you're talking about you travel a lot for your job. What is your job besides YouTube creator extraordinaire?
Yeah. So I'm a manufacturer's rep. So I work for all these different manufacturers who make commercial door hardware. And my specialty is electronics. So if you've ever been into a building, maybe at work, where you have to use a card to get through the door, you'll put it up, right? So I make the companies I represent make that stuff. So I represent them. I go around, travel parts of the country, and
did we lose Mike?
On that about six years.
All right, cool. I lost you for a quick second there, but looks like you were able to finish it up. Are you flying around the country, or are you really driving to everywhere you need to go?
You say that again, I lost you.
I said, are you flying around the country, or are you just driving in that area?
Yeah, mostly driving. So for the most part, I cover a three-state territory, which is Ohio, Michigan, and Indiana. But our factories are located all over the country. So just recently I was in New Haven, Connecticut. I had to fly out for an overnight trip. I might go out to Phoenix, Arizona. There's a factory out there. Las Vegas once or twice a year for big trade shows. So, right. Yeah. it's a good fair amount of travel.
You're talking my language there when you talk about Vegas.
Yeah.
When you head out there next time, let me know, and we'll you know, it's 3 hours away. We'll drive over and see you.
Yeah, for sure. For sure.
All right. Very cool. Very cool. Bottle Cap Barbecue just said, come to Phoenix. He's from Phoenix there. So
yeah. Cool. Next time I'm in Phoenix, I'll give you a shout.
Right on. Right on. I see Smoking Joe's Barbecue's here. So that's Little Joe. Although both Joes are fairly large gentlemen, I think. But Pit Barbecue gets the big Joe. And the other one's just Barbecue. So he's a Little Joe. All right. So, guys, before we go on to the next couple questions, I want you to make sure that you are – I assume everybody in the chat's subbed to everybody, but guys, if you're not subbed to like Kent, myself, Mike, any of the moderators, anybody in the chat, let's, you know, help support each other's community. It's not sub for sub. Everybody in the chat here watches everybody else's channels. So it's not like we're, you know, like not supporting. So don't think that. But Kent is, what, 18 subs away from 500. So let's help get Kent there. And then Mike's stuck in the 800s. So let's help him get to 1,000. And I know a couple other people in the chat are trying to grow too. So let's help, you know, be a community and help support each other. I know Josh and Babe are sitting in the 800s too. So let's get them going. And I think Mel is sitting in the 800s too. So guys, all the links are below. If any of the moderators want to put links in the chat, feel free. If you see somebody in the chat you want to connect with, hit the three dots next to their comment, go to the channel, hit subscribe. So everybody's trying to grow here. Everybody's trying to do the same thing. So let's help each other out, all right? That's all I'm going to say about that one, all right? Kent, you got a couple questions. I'm going to send it to you for a moment.
Yeah, I got a couple for Mike. First one for you, Mike, comes from Rob V out on CJ's Coast. Who's going to bring Cleveland the next championship, the Cavs or the Browns?
The Browns. The Browns. I think the Cavs are done. You know, you lose a guy like LeBron twice, and you watch what happens to the team, unless we can really pull something off. But I think the Cavs are done for a while. So I'm gonna put my chips on the Brownies. Good question.
I'm waiting for Jay to Leprechaun to pipe up about all the Brownies needed was a baker.
I'll tell you what, that Baker kid, he's got something for sure. He's got whatever factor it is, but he's a killer dude.
We've seen a lot of quarterbacks come through here, and this guy's the most exciting that I've seen. In a long time.
And it doesn't seem like he's overly arrogant or anything like that. I mean, he knows he's a good player, but I don't feel like he's, you know, one of them guys that are entitled and whatever. So
yeah, like a Johnny Manziel.
Right. Fair enough. That's funny.
You know, I get a kick out of it, Mike, just for the fact, you know, they showed the list of starting quarterbacks for the Browns compared to in the last, what, 22 years? And it was like 34 different quarterbacks.
Yeah, it's insane,
that's
man.
I mean, that's nuts.
And the head coaches are almost as bad.
What's that?
The head coaches are almost as bad as the quarterbacks.
Well, I don't know why a guy goes 1-31 and keeps a job, but whatever.
So, hey, dude. Kent, hold on. James Ryan said Chinese pickled chicken feet with Korean, I assume, barbecue sauce, authentic kimchi made from fermented fish. Put a southern twist on that, CJ. James, I don't know if I have the chops for that one, but I'm eager to learn that right there. So welcome. And Dan's Outdoor Cooking is a Bengals fan, so – good for you. And Meat Cranium's here. So welcome, guys. Welcome, welcome. Merry Christmas, James. Thanks for joining in. All right, Ken, go ahead. Sorry, brother. I had to read that out loud. I didn't want to miss it on the scroll over.
I saw that and I was chuckling. I was like, that's a dish there.
I don't know if there's a Southern twist. I don't know. I'll get with Mike and Kent on that. We'll see what we can do.
There we go. All right. Speaking of your Browns, Corey, Cooking with Corey out of Lincoln, wants to know if you're a spokesman for the Browns, Mike.
I am today. So I got to represent. I know Leprechaun's watching, and he'd be super disappointed if I didn't have some kind of Brownies gear with all this Christmas stuff. So.
All right.
Love my Browns.
Yeah, I could. You'd probably get death threat. Death threat. God, I can't talk tonight.
Plus, Leprechaun. Plus, he knows where I live now, so I got to be careful.
Well, that's your own damn fault. Okay. One last question I have for right now from Mr. Mega Fred Zeppelin wants to know, Mike, have you barbecued any tri-tip yet?
No. Never cooked tri-tip. I don't know why. I really don't have. I don't have a smoker or anything yet. I've got my little PK grill, and
perfect.
Yeah, I don't know. Every time I see tri-tip, I just think of people smoking it. But it's something I'm going to do this summer for sure, and I'll be watching your guys' videos to see.
I do mine on my kettle.
We do them all the time on like even a gasser. Like the tri-tip doesn't take that long. You don't need to smoke that thing.
No. I would reverse sear it with a nice, well, to be honest with you, the last one I did was a rub I just got in the mail from this little company in Porter, Texas called Heaven Made Products. And, I tell you what, my wife loved it. So
yeah,
I would reverse sear it. There's 100 of them videos out there. And
yeah.
It's the way to go on. It really is. So,
and
yeah, I'm looking forward to trying it.
Tri-tip out here is so ready available, dude. It's you know, probably one of the least expensive, you know, roast size cuts of meat out here too. So, yeah. That's something I've been cooking for years. I had no idea. Like, obviously now I get to talk to all these, you know, fine people from across the country, and I had no idea that tri-tip was so, you know, not available around the world.
I've never seen it in a store here. Leprechaun called me up this summer asking me if I wanted one, but that and picanha. So, yeah.
You know, the thing is, I haven't seen picanha out by me. Granted, I haven't really been looking for it, but I haven't seen it in the supermarkets or whatever. Like I see
trucks.
Hobo and Red buy it all. That's why they can't get it anywhere else. So. All right, I got one more thing, and then I'll kick it back to you, CJ. More of a comment for Mike than it is a question. Comes from Smoking Joe's Barbecue, so little Joe. It says, hey, can't tell Mike he's one of the most talented cooks on YouTube. So there you go, pal.
Wow. Thank you, Joe. I appreciate that. There's a lot of cooks on YouTube, and I'm glad to know that I'm in your top 10 there.
Yeah, thanks, man. He's never given me a compliment like that. So, dude, you're doing good, bro.
Time to up the game there, CJ.
What's that?
Time to up your game.
Yeah, I know, right? I don't know. Mike, I watch your videos, and I'm taking down names real quick. But you are doing such a great job with, you know, the production value of everything. It's pretty inspiring, dude. You're doing good stuff, brother.
Thanks, man. I spent a lot of time trying to figure out the cameras and the lighting and all that. And now the trick is just to get people to come watch the videos. So
right.
I'll be spending a lot more time on thumbnails and titles here in the next couple months.
Well, you know, everybody says you got to win the click, so you got to spend time on your thumbnails. I've learned that myself, too. Like, I seriously, when I do my thumbnails now, I set them up on a nice cutting board. I have a white board that sits behind it. I sit it on a white like poster board or whatever.
Yeah.
I turn off all the lights. I try to do it like Steve from Not Another Cooking Show. Like, yeah. I am really trying hard on these thumbnails. And sometimes I forget. Like, I'll start eating and doing the taste test. I'm like, son of a bitch.
I've done that so many times, man. And then I got to go back and try and get something out of the camera footage instead of a nice still picture. Yeah.
Tom Horseman said thumbnails like question mark. Tom, they're not everybody's naturally as talented as you are on your stuff. So, Tom, you're a special case for sure. So, speaking of Tom, welcome, brother. Good to see you. Shane from Never Trust the Skinny Chefs here. Smoking Bears is here. Robert from Soul Food Cooking. Donna David's in the house. Now, not trying to start anything. Is Donna your wife or your girlfriend?
Girlfriend.
Okay, well, so when is she going to be your wife? Oh, snap. No, anyway. Barbecue, Pit Dog, Big Rob's in the house. And Beers, Jack, and Barbecue. I think that kind of caught everybody. So let's just kind of flow that into the question. Talk about your family life. Obviously, you got Donna there. Do you have kids, dogs, cats?
Yeah, it's me, Donna, and Remy. So if you've seen some of my videos, I've got a little miniature schnauzer. And Donna pops in on my live streams every now and again. So it's three of us, no kids. So that's how we're living.
That's how you're gonna be. Now, we got Josh and Babe on here. It was, a lot of people in the chat were like saying, "Make her, an honest woman, put a ring on it, whatever." Are you gonna be subject to that same kind of instruction and ridicule or whatever? I already seen you put a ring on it.
Donna and I have been together a long time, and we just figure if it ain't broke, don't fix it, right? So,
all right, cool. Keep it at that. So, if you guys want to do the super chat for a ring fund for Mike, so he doesn't have the excuse anymore, it's not broke, don't fix it. You need to be with all of us in the same loving relationship, marriage that we all have.
Oh, that's funny.
Sorry, I'm just playing, man. Let's see here. Let's kind of get into the Sherry L in the hot seat now, Mike. someone said ring pop is 35 cents. So there you go, brother.
There we go.
Speaking of Donna, do you want her to come in real quick? She's more than welcome to come and say hi.
Yeah, I think she'll pop in at some point during this. I know she was keeping the dog outside, and she's out in the man cave right now watching. So
right on. Dogs are welcome to be on the chat too. We love dogs around here for sure. I love schnauzers too, man. So I want to see, the puppy. All right. So let's kind of go into the channel questions now. How'd you get started? You said you've had your channel for a long time now. What started it? How long ago was it? What prompted you to do the cooking or whatever? Let's talk about the channel a bit.
Yeah, so I started my first YouTube channel back in, I don't even know, when YouTube first started. There was a winery out in California, I'm not going to say who it is, who had this video contest where you cook something up, the video's got to be 3 minutes long, feature their wine in it, and you could win a trip out to their vineyard, all the expenses paid. And that was the very first time I made a cooking video. It was an awesome video. I got to redo it. But the whole thing turned out to be kind of a scam. I met Ballistic Greg from Ballistic Barbecue. He was in that. His video was freaking awesome. There was a couple other people back then, but it was a big scam. It was one of those where they let some employee win. It was the worst video of them all. So then that kind of kicked off that channel. I did that for a couple of years. And I had some success then, but my camera sucked. My computer was slow. Then a bunch of other stuff happened. We moved, and the kitchen that you guys see now was 1965 original green appliances, just terrible, like fake bricks all over the place. So I said, you know what? I'm done. My channel looks like shit. I'm watching all these other people with,
Mike, great kitchens. Your camera fell asleep.
So all these other people with great kitchens, Every time I wanted to grill outside, I was standing next to a garbage can. And I just said, I'm done. And over the past couple of years, we've remodeled. And now we've got the space to do it. So I'm excited to give it another go.
Right on. What, how long did you, well, you did the remodel on your kitchen. Did you do it yourself? Did you have people come in? Are you that handy that you remodeled your kitchen by yourself?
We did some of it. So all the demolition, that's easy. You know, take everything down to the studs. Donna designed the whole thing. Picked out the colors and all that good stuff. I didn't want to install cabinets. I don't know if you guys have ever done that before, but in these older houses, the walls are never even, right?
Right.
So trying to get everything to look good. We had someone do that. And then we blew out the wall. So like in the beginning of my videos where you guys see me standing, that used to be a solid wall. We had that knocked down by some contractors. So it was done right. And put in that island, but the electricity, all that other stuff I did, the under cabinet lights. Right on. So it kind of took a lot of the expense out of it.
Right on. That's cool, man. And the fact that you did it yourself is just a huge thing, man. Like a lot of people don't have the fortitude to do that. I'm myself included. I would probably get nice and frustrated and break more shit than I fix. So I'm serious, man. We took out the island in our kitchen and put that big one that you see me kind of sit at.
And
we called somebody in on that one because I tried to remove the island that we had there. It was a little, like half the size, and we ended up breaking it on the way out. I mean, it's just, you know.
Right.
The building
a lot of times
is horrible. So, you know, the stuff wasn't put together very well. But I just figured at that point we need to get a professional in there. Especially if we put electricity into that bad boy. I did not want to fry myself for sure. So
I think a lot of homeowners try to do something themselves and then end up costing double or triple, you know, because someone's got to come in and fix all the mistakes.
Right.
So you just kind of do what you're comfortable with.
I blame HGTV, man. It's at least with cooking, you know, because I watch tons of cooking network, or Food Network, whatever. At least with that, you mess up, you just throw it in the trash, whatever. You course pizza. You try to do like fixer upper style, you burn down your damn house. So,
right. HGTV and Pinterest.
Yes. Let's see here. Hot Sauce Daily, how you doing? Good to see you in there. What did you miss? You missed about half hour worth of questions in chat, but feel free to go back and check it out and you get caught up. Let's see here. Jay Wade's here. How you doing, Jay Wade? And James from Amy McClain's here. How you doing, James? Good to see you. We got 56 in the chat. We're doing good. Thanks a lot, Keith, for keeping track of for us. So when you're doing your filming, obviously it looks very well done. Tell us about your camera, whatever you're using to film, lighting, the whole bit. Tell me about how you do it.
Yeah, so I got a Canon. It's a EOS M50, and it's kind of your entry level. It's an entry level DSLR, right? Some of these cameras cost $2,000-$3,000. This one was like $700, so a little bit of an investment there. I've got two photo deox LED lights that I have on both sides of my camera. Like even right now for this live stream, I've got two lights coming in. Keep it well lit. And then I have a variety of lenses that I use depending on, you know, what I'm trying to film. So my opening shots, the big wide view, that's a nice wide angle lens. If I'm doing my thumbnails, I use a 50 millimeter. So for Canon, they call it the Nifty 50. And that gets you real nice tight shots. So that's kind of the deal. I got a tripod. And then I've got a couple other cameras that I'm trying to figure out how to use or mount so they're not getting in the way for future videos. But ultimately, I want to have the one set up, and then I want to have Donna with the second one doing some following me around the kitchen kind of stuff that I can edit in there. So if you look at Sam the Cooking Guy, Right. That guy's super inspirational to me. That's kind of what I'm going for. It's entertaining to watch. So,
yeah, I like Sam the Cooking Guy. I follow him. He's a Southern California boy too. I think his son does such a great job with the way they do it. Max is his film.
Yeah, Max. Yep.
Just they do outstanding work on there, and he's one of those guys that just don't give a darn at all, man. He just freaking hammers it out, and you know, says whatever's on the mind. Half the time they bleep it out, half the time they don't. So
right.
It's hilarious. I look forward to it. So, Bill just dropped a super chat from Chicken Fried Barbecue, my favorite channel name out there. So, Bill said he can't hear a damn thing. So, thanks. I put it in the chat too. Thanks. So, shout out to Bill from Chicken Fried Barbecue, another channel that's scheduled for the future. Can't wait. Let's see here. James Ryan, I'm watching 3 live streams at the same time and watching comments. Damn, I'm a YouTube sicko. Help me. Hey, you know, speaking of YouTube sickos, I haven't seen Nigel in a week or so. Hope he's all right. So, Nigel, if you're catching the rerun, hope you're doing good, brother. Mike Montoya's here in UTS Studios is here. That's new to my channel, so welcome. Glad you're here. We appreciate it. You're talking about the different lenses and angles.
I'm just getting a beer.
You getting another beer? All right, cool.
Yeah, it's all good. I can hear you.
You got to stay lubricated or hydrated. Sorry, hydrated.
Hydrated. Yeah, go ahead.
Did you just say lubricated?
I meant hydrated.
Jesus, where's your mind at?
Hey, why, Meat Cranium asked if I was being a naughty boy. I don't know why. But I can get Miss CJ down here, and she can talk about my naughtiness or not, whatever.
It's your hashtag pillow behind you is why you asked.
got it. The hobo said, I always stay lubricated. I walked into that one. Fair enough. Let's see here. Chat's going strong. I love the hashtags. Christy, put your hashtag in the description. And in the title, if you want, I did both, and it'll take you where you're at. Yeah, I see the hashtag naughty. Sorry. Pillow biting. Whatever. Let's see here. In case anybody cares, I'm drinking Myers rum tonight. Shout out to my pops. His birthday was yesterday. I was hoping he'd come in the chat tonight. I don't know if it's past his bedtime. He is 70 years old, so he might be a little tired right now. John McGuire, how you doing, brother? What did you walk into? We're talking about pillow biting and being naughty, so welcome. You don't get that on your podcast, do you? By the way, dude, John, whenever you want to come on here, let me know if you want me to come on the podcast, dude. I'd love to chat with you guys. I'd love your guys' podcast. That'd be awesome. We'll get some of these jokers in the chat, too. So what I was saying when you got your beer, you were talking about having different lenses and whatnot in – you know, what or how, I guess, how did you learn which lenses to use? My Canon that I have is just a POS, you know, the cheapest one that I could find, and it has one lens. It's just a stationary lens or non-interchangeable. So how did you know?
So this is something that on YouTube, I spend more time watching camera videos, how to use this. This is all new to me in the past 6 months. So Peter McKinnon, I'm sure everyone's heard of Peter McKinnon. If you haven't, you should write his name down. So he's always doing some good educational stuff. There's another guy named Peter Gregg, and you guys should definitely check him out. He does, I don't want to call him tutorials, but he'll go over like Canon cameras and Sony. And he happened to have a video on this camera, you know. So you just start putting all this stuff together. And then comes the hard part where you got to fork over the cash, you know. This stuff is not cheap. So I didn't buy it all at once. I bought one light one day. I bought, you know, a lens a month later. And I've just been building it up. And that's what I kind of talk about is I would love to have a really nice, like, big green egg or some other, you know, nice smoker. But right now I'm investing the money into gear to help this channel, you know, maintain a level of quality that I'm trying to do.
Right. Fair enough. Yeah. Cookie McCory asked where his 8x10 is. Brother, send me your address again, and I'll get you on. I'll get you on next week. Phil from Daddy Cooks is back from Parts Unknown. Welcome back, Phil. Appreciate you stopping by. So glad you're back in the States. So glad you're going to be making videos again. Very cool, man. Tom's Food Factory's here, and Deep Sea Barbecue. Trevor is here, so welcome, welcome. Mike, I think you're right. By doing what you do, you know, get the film part of it straight and narrow, and then worry about the extra cooks you're doing, because you could do what you're doing on your stove and in the oven, whatever. I know Leprechaun's probably pushing you to be a black stoner for sure.
But I do have a black stone.
You do? Oh, that's right. I've seen a live with it. Yeah. That's right.
I haven't done too many with it yet. That'll be something this summer. Right now, it's just so much easier to have all this stuff set up inside. I know where to put everything. You know what I mean?
Right.
As soon as I go outside, it's full sun. You know, it just looks like shit. So I'm just not there yet to do the stuff outside. But I've got the Blackstone, and I would love to cook on it more with the videos.
Yeah, I said something to Leprechaun about that earlier. Like, I love cooking on the Blackstone. I wish I could do it more, but I'm doing my best to cater my videos towards what is going to give me the most views right now. And that's with the air fryer and the foodie and all that stuff.
Oh, so, for sure. For sure.
You know, I'm trying to drive and grow. So I'm with you on that, but, I want one of them green eggs really bad too.
Yeah,
I know they're pretty pricey. But I see. All right, the Camp Chef versus freaking Blackstone's already going off in the chat. Bunch of crazy kids. I thought I saw Donna for a hot second. Is she?
Yeah, she'll be right back. She's getting herself a little glass of wine over there.
Right on, right on.
She'll be back.
All right. Let's. Kent, I haven't seen you send me any messages. Do you have any questions?
Oh yeah, I got plenty.
All right, let's go ahead and go to Kent, and we'll come back in a couple questions.
All right. Well, first of all, I'm screwed on this Camp Chef versus Blackstone thing because I don't want to beat. So say what you want. first thing is, Mike Hobo has a comment for you, and he said, if you want to borrow anything of his cookers, I'm assuming he means. He says, come borrow whatever you want. So, Chris.
Yeah, man. Chris Hobo, I've seen some of his pictures and videos. That dude has got a ton of really cool stuff. So,
let's talk about Hobo's wood for a second. Yeah, a huge collection of wood.
He does. He's got it all nice.
It's so weird to compliment on his wood. So, let's see here. All right. Sorry, Kent. Had to go on a tangent. Yeah.
You done?
Nah, probably.
Okay, my turn. All right. Speaking of smokers, Mike, Smoking Joe's Pit Barbecue wants to know, when are you actually going to get a smoker? And if and when you do, which one do you want?
Yeah, so it's an interesting thing. I happen to be the only one in this household that likes smoked food. So I'm not sure how much money I'm willing to put into it, but I want to get one this summer. I know those videos are super popular, and I want to learn it and get good at it. I've had smokers in the past. I had a Masterbuilt upright propane. You guys call them easy bake ovens.
I hated that. We can't say that. Jason's here.
Oh, that's right. Jason, easy bake. And nothing against him at all. But I did not like that thing. My biggest problem with that one was trying to clean up. It was just a pain in the ass to clean that thing. Prior to that, I had an offset smoker from a big box store. It was made of real thin sheet metal, impossible for me to, especially being a novice, I just could not control the temperature of that thing. So after about a year, I put that out on the tree lawn. But I'm looking at, you know, I got a small yard. So I'm really looking at like a pit barrel cooker, something that's not going to take up a huge footprint. And with a little bit of smoking that I do, you know, I think that's
sorry, I was laughing at Donna there. So,
hey, you want to say hi? Here.
Hi, everybody. We're having issues in the garage. I can't, the internet's not working in the garage. So I just completely missed the first half hour trying to figure out what's going on out there. Cause he's got his microphone on and the earbud on, and I'm missing everything.
Yeah. Yeah. We were going to film out in the garage, but, the internet's terrible today for some reason. So,
well, welcome Donna. I appreciate you stopping by in there. You know, it's always good to see you. We love seeing, the not spouses, significant others come on and chat and hang out for a little bit. Not trying the to put anything out there, Mike.
I'm sorry. That's cool.
It's all good. It's all good. And hey, we're going to do a quick shot.
Hold on.
Yeah,
hold on.
Yeah. Get your
shot. Everybody get a shot.
Everybody get your drinks ready. Get your drinks.
Yeah, if you guys like honey, this is Baron Jaeger. I know Kent's got his rumpel over there.
Oh, yeah. You know I do, buddy.
You guys got to try this Baron Jaeger. It's a honey liqueur. It's
even
good
if you don't like honey.
Good in small
like
doses,
it.
Yeah. So
or
let's do
good
this.
Good in large doses. Like.
All right. Well, everybody get their drinks out. You know, we'll have a toast. Let you guys do a toast to everybody. I know Phil's back. We're glad you got home safely from parts unknown, and I know you got a nice probably a Doors white label on the rocks in front of you. So cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Oh, there it is, some Doors. Cheers.
Here we go.
Cheers, guys.
Ah, mazel. Good stuff, boys.
Oh yeah.
Woo. What are you drinking, Donna? Besides half that shot,
just a red wine, Malbec.
So how's that working out with the honey shot?
Oh, I'm fine.
We're hardcore over here.
I might switch to beer in a minute. Just give me time.
You should go to the gambit. Right on. You guys can come over here and hang out with the thing behind me over here.
Yeah, you got a good collection back there.
We got options up in this place. I really do feel like an alcoholic sometimes, but, you know, alcoholics are, you know, I'm a drunk. Let's just say that. alcoholics go to meetings. See, Phil and Florence is here. Welcome, Phil. Piff, how you doing, brother?
No giveaway, Piff.
Oh, it's all right. I think Phil actually just likes hanging out with us. I don't think he's here for the giveaways anymore. All right.
You know why that is? He has to buy another lot next door if he wins anything else.
Right on. Go. You got a couple more questions, I know. Go ahead, brother.
Yeah, I sure do. Right. Bottle Cap Barbecue wants to know, Mike, do you use an independent voice recorder or do you record to your camera?
I record to my camera. So all of my videos up until my grilled cheese video, I used a lapel, a wired lapel mic. So I got a 15-foot cord. Terrible tripping over that thing.
Oh, I'm with you, dude.
I'm clumsy enough as it is. And then on top of it, you have no idea if the battery dies on that thing. So I have ruined a couple videos where here I am talking away and there's no audio. So I've upgraded. My next video will have a wireless lav mic, and that's got an indicator. It'll tell me whether or not it's working, you know, a visual indicator. Right. But again, that'll plug directly into the camera.
That's so cool. I was, to interject, I told you my camera dumped on me, right? So all I had a Rode mic on it, and I have a wireless lavalier mic too. and I couldn't figure, I've been using my phone to film my last few videos, and I couldn't figure out how to put my lavalier wireless mic together on my phone. It was just driving me up a wall. But I had a wired microphone, like you said you're using, and I would put that up in the kitchen, and then I'd have to like tuck it in, you know, move it around, whatever, knock a tripod over. So I finally used this. I found another attachment, figured it out. I got it on my phone, so we're doing good stuff there. And
nice.
Hopefully, it just made me laugh when you're talking about tripping over that wire, dude. It's so, so bad.
Yeah, been there, done that. You know.
I hate it. Anyway, I see a new friend that's joined us over there.
Yeah. So this is Remy. He's our mini schnauzer. He's a big mini schnauzer. He's like 20. How heavy is he? 25 pounds.
25 pounds.
Damn. That's a big boy.
Big boy. If you guys want a guard dog, like he's not going to stop anybody from coming in. But if you want to know if somebody's on the property, I always joke, nobody steps foot on a blade of grass around here without us knowing about it. So super awesome dog. We love him.
That's Ben. Okay.
That's adorable.
So that's the whole family there.
Dogs in the
videos.
Ken and I were talking about that. I think it was this week, right? Jack was in one of your videos licking the propane tank. I want to cook outside more. We were talking about that, and I was trying to work around my dog Charlie, the pug back there, and it's his domain. You know, you're in his world, so you just got to kind of let him flow with it. And we've all made barbecue pit dogs, Duke a star, because everybody loves that dog. So
I think
the trend in 2019 is more dogs in your videos, and I don't mean Marion and Robert Roy cooking the dogs.
No.
Yeah, he came over. He tried to take the dog home with him. All right, Kent. Sorry, boy.
All right. What's Mike? Mike getting in? Oh, there he's back. Okay, I'm going to ask this because two different people have put it in the chat. Both, I think Bottle Cap did, and I think Rob D did. And he said, and they both asked the same question. What's in the box, Mike?
What's in the box?
What's in the box?
When the Paltrow's hit. Oh, sorry.
I don't know if I started this or not, but I've seen a bunch of live streams lately where people doing a what's in the box. And that all just started, I travel, you know, and I was trying to figure out this live stream stuff, and I thought it'd be a cool idea, let people guess what's in the box. Who knew that that's what I've become famous for? So thanks, guys.
All right, that's cool. That's funny. I like that. Chris at Eastwind wants to know, after your remodel, you mentioned all your under cabinet lights, everything else. You're running two cameras when you shoot videos. How much has your power bill went up?
It's actually gone down because everything's LED. And the lights nowadays, I'm not sure if you guys have switched over to LEDs yet, but
yeah,
very low power consumption.
It'll go up tonight just because of this chandelier with the old
chandelier lights. Above us is like the one light in the house.
Really bad.
The real question is, how much is our electricity bill going to go up with all of the Christmas? You should see the front of our house. And
hey, you got to do Christmas like I do. There's no lights on this bad boy right here.
That's brilliant.
It's not gonna happen.
Well, you know, Donna, what I'm not mentioning is the three other fucking Christmas trees in our house.
In the house. Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. we got more.
Yeah,
CJ went a little out of control this year.
Hey, you leave Mr. CJ alone.
Hey,
yes, sir.
That's my gal. Back off, mister.
All right.
All right, couple more for you real quick, Mike. Jim at Suburban Barbecue wanted to know, you alluded to it earlier, some of your DIY projects you did.
Mm-hmm.
What type of projects did you do?
Well, my most popular video is a pergola that I put up. It's this grid system, and it's pretty sweet. It's these metal, I don't even know how to describe it, but post holders, I guess, decorative post holders. It goes right on the surface of the patio. You throw your 4x4s in, and you can build this thing in sections, and then you put up a canopy. It's for shade purposes only. And it's a kit, and it's something any homeowner can do. That one is what really got me interested in doing videos again. I threw that thing up. It was a terrible video. It got like 15,000 views in just a couple months. Another one that I did was like your if you have vinyl siding and you have a weed whacker, chances are in the bottom corner, someone has beat that thing to shit. So I showed a video on how to replace that without taking all of your siding down. That was really popular. I did a Ring doorbell. So those video camera doorbells, a couple other stuff like that. There weren't many of them because I quickly realized how expensive this was all getting to do these videos and time consuming. But I've recently taken those videos down because YouTube, pardon me, doesn't quite know where to show my content. I'm getting all this traffic from DIY and not as much for the cooking, which is what I want my channel to be. So I took those down and we'll see if it helps me. But
now, is that affecting your watch hours? Like you said, they were pretty popular.
Yeah. So what I did, and I'll have to double check this. I didn't delete them. I just unlisted them.
Yeah.
And so I think my watch hours are still there, but I won't know. I did it 2 or 3 days ago.
There's an app I downloaded that shows how many subscribers you have and how many watch hours you have for the year. I'll screenshot it to you and send it to you.
Yeah.
It's you know, it becomes like I'm a little obsessive with all the stats.
Yeah.
And checking, you know, subscribers and whatever, blah, 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 you know. So I'm in my phone a lot. But it's good to know where you're at as far as having the watch hours, because eventually you're going to hit that 1,000 subscriber mark, and you may just want to, if it's affecting your watch hours, keep it on unlisted, then once you hit that 1,000, you may just want to flip those back into public to get those hours back on there. Maybe give it a shot. Or you know, I made a couple videos unlisted too, and I don't remember it affecting it going down or anything like that. So
yeah, I don't think it has, but I'll check, you know. Yeah. But yeah, send me that. I would love to have that app.
All right, cool. So again, guys, we're trying to get Kent to 500 and we're trying to get Mike to 1,000. So if you guys aren't subscribed to them, the links are down below in the show more. If any of the mods want to throw the links in there, go ahead. Let's get them going. Okay. Let's see here. Kent, you said you had one or two more.
I got one more. Smoking Joe's Pit Barbecue. So Big Joe. Mike, what editing software do you use?
Adobe Premiere Pro. I know it's super expensive, but if you guys can, I would recommend to everybody, if this YouTube thing is something you're really trying to grow with, as soon as you can, start using that software, because there's so much you can do in there. And that's what I'm using.
So not iMovie, like, you know, us poor slaps do. All right, cool.
Yeah.
I wanted to say it, but you beat me to the punch.
I fear change, right? I've used iMovie from the jump. So I wouldn't mind, you know, stepping up or paying for it or whatever. I'm scared to change it, you know?
Yeah. So, Donna's got a good point. So the first thing is, when I first started making my first couple videos, I used whatever was on my Windows machine, some Windows Movie Maker, and I was getting the hang of it, you know. But I thought I would rather start learning now at the beginning, you know, than to make it 2 years and then I'll never change. And so what Adobe does is they'll let you do a subscription. You just pay by the month. and right. it's not a whole lot. And I figured I'm going to try it out for a month, and if I just can't do it, then at least I didn't have to pay for the whole thing, you know? So, but you're right. It's a big learning curve, and one more thing you got to learn. So
yeah,
I get it.
You know, through these chats, we've all talked about it, that YouTube is a learning process, and I don't think anybody has it down totally pat. There's something to learn. You know, I do spend a lot of time watching, you know, the Nick Nimmons and all of them to try to grow the channel too, and learn any little tips I can too. So I'm with you on doing that stuff. So maybe I will look into that. You know, someone said director, what, Daddy Cooks and Hobo use, what is it, Power Director. So I don't know if that's
there's a lot though. There's so many different ones you can use. And, you know, so many of them are good anyways.
Right.
You know, it doesn't necessarily mean you have to spend a lot of money to just put the time in to do it, I guess.
Right.
Yeah.
But I don't do it.
It's the learning process and whether you want to put the time in there. Soul Food Cooking, I think it's Robert, I don't believe it's his wife, said that they use what you use too. And it took a while to learn it, but that's been worth it for them. So, hey, so guys, you know, take note. If you watch Mike's videos, you're doing good things. Like just even the last video I watched, you had some nice little pop-ups and the Christmas type
stuff. Subscribe.
All those drop-ins. That's stuff that I haven't found on iMovie at all. So I know that's – I don't know if that's an option or not, but, you know, those are the type of things that make or break a channel and make you grow a little bit more. And, you know, we've talked about editing with, you know, like Justin the Baby Back Maniac and Steve from Nine Other Cookie Show. They put a lot of time and effort in their editing, and they do such a great job. And
yeah, for sure.
Mr. CJ just dropped a super chat for $1.99. What a sweetheart.
All right.
Cute. Aw. It's kind of cheap in my mind. Only $1? Really? I guess I'm not that cute. So.
Yes, you are.
Thank you. There you go. At least someone loves me. All right. Cool. Kent, you got one more, and then I'll take it back over, please.
Yeah, I do, because it had to do with the Premiere Pro. He was the editing software he was just talking about. Jim at
she said it's for Kent.
Yeah, I know. I already thanked her.
Oh, there you go.
And then
someone in the chat asked how many gals you have. So I think it's Mrs. CJ and Babe, and then Donna. Are you going to be part of Kent's tribe too?
Sure.
He's a collector over there.
Uh-huh. All right, I'm up to four now.
All right, brother. You're
and Mr. Dutt.
Iowa pimping, exactly, Hobo.
Chris. All right. So what, Mike? And let's get back on subject here. What PC are you using to run the Premiere Pro on? Suburban one, you know.
Yeah, I use a Dell XPS 27. It's about 5 years old. It's an all-in-one. It's got a touch screen, which helps with Photoshop, you know, if you have a stylus and all that stuff. But here's the thing. That computer, and I'm sure most computers are going to be like this, if you're filming at 60 frames per second, the computer's not going to be able to handle it. It's going to bog down. So you're going to need more horsepower. So what I do is I film at 24 frames per second most of the time because it's a smaller file. And then if I need to do some slow-mo, I'll record in like a quick clip in 60. But I found that the computer has a hard time rendering the videos. So I don't recommend getting my computer. It just happens to be what I have.
Okay. Hope that answers your question, Jim. All right, CJ, back to you. But Eastwind, Mel's, and Corey, I do have your questions wrote down for Mike for later. And Bottle Cap, we are not asking that question tonight. So deal with it.
Deal with it. All right. So I see a couple more people jumped in the chat. Joey B, I saw him roll through a little earlier in Rally Smoke. Welcome, guys. So we talked about the cooker you want to have or the smokers you want to have, but what are you using right now besides your kitchen? You have the Blackstone. What else do you got out there?
I've got a Weber Q that I really love. It's a little tiny. I'm sure you guys have seen them. Little tiny Weber propane grill is perfect for two of us. So I don't have to heat up this giant grill to cook two burgers. And then I've got the PK grill that you guys have seen.
Right.
Or some of you have seen. That thing's really cool looking, retro, cast aluminum. It'll never rust. But I'm really not that happy with it, to be honest with you. It's a pain in the ass to clean out the ash. I miss my old Weber.
We've had so many
grills. We've had a bunch of grills.
We've had so many.
But your standard, you know, Weber grill, it's got the ash tray underneath and the ash falls down.
Right. The kettle. The kettle is what you're talking
about. Yeah, the kettle. Yep.
You were talking about smokers earlier, and I'm surprised no one threw that in the chat. Like, what about just getting a plain old Weber kettle and, you know, and rolling the smoke that way?
It's not as cool for a video, though.
Fair enough. Yeah. The big green egg is very impressive.
Yeah. But, yeah, so that's all I use. And then, of course, you know, the Blackstone. In the summertime, we probably use that twice a week, you know?
We cook up. In the summertime, we cook up. We don't cook inside.
Yeah, almost every night we're outside cooking. Yeah. So.
Have you done any videos with that Weber Q? Because I've noticed that a Fire Escape Griller, remember he was on a few months ago, and that's all he used. And he seemed to create a little niche with that you don't see too many Weber Qs out there.
No, you don't. So he was the deciding factor when I bought mine. You know, I like to do my research on YouTube. Who's using them? What are the reviews? And he just had video after video doing all kinds of awesome stuff. But I haven't done anything yet with that, and maybe I should. Yeah, that was kind of a specialty buy. My intention.
Last winter, actually, right?
Yeah, last winter. I do a lot of sous vide cooking.
Okay.
And so when I sous vide a steak or a burger, I want something that heats up quick, put a quick sear on it. And the whole idea was that's all I'm going to use that for. There's barely any grease that drips when you do sous vide, right?
Right.
Because all you're doing is that quick sear.
And it was the middle of winter.
Middle of winter. But I like it so much that we use it. I mean, we just used it two nights ago to cook up some burgers.
Oh,
so.
And steaks.
And steaks, yeah. It's just a quick, easy thing to fire up and not have to mess with, you know, charcoal and all that.
Right. Then I think that's a lot of people feel that way about the gassers. I mean, I love smoke, you know, barbecue, whatever. But we're having people over on Sunday for Christmas, Ms. CJ's side of the family, and we're gonna make a taco bar, you know, using carne asada and pollo asada, whatever. And that for me, it's just a tons easier getting on the. I have a Weber Genesis, you know, a gas or grill. It's just easier to do that. You don't have to mess with the charcoal. You don't have to clean up. It's just one and done, right? So I'm with you on that. I would, if it were me, I would do more on that Weber Q, or do that, do the sous vide part of the video too. I know sous vide is very big, you know, freaking get an Amazon link for your sous vide machine and your Weber Q, and you can start making Amazon money, you know what I'm saying? So
yeah,
just my two cents, you know, I don't know nothing about nothing, but you know, I think you could do pretty well with that. Just the way you do your videos, and it's so clean and so edited very well. And I know it's sometimes a pain in the ass to shoot outside, but you know, the end result might be worth it for you. So just something to think about.
You're right. You're right.
I see Maria is here, Maria's World, and Marion from Robert Roy. We were just talking about you earlier. Why you not treat Mrs. CJ family with the respect of charcoal? Because, Hobo, they don't know the fucking difference.
I just got to grab a beer.
All right. Hobo, your hashtags, as much as I love your hashtags, too long is hard to handle, brother. And I know that's what she said, but it's a little too much. So let's see here. Marion, we were talking about you earlier, about you wanted to take Charlie home with you when you were here for the meetup. So I think you missed that one. But
he's born another one.
What's that?
See,
he's born another one.
He's oh, just yeah. trying to keep pace.
I see him get a new beer. I'm like, I got to do something. and I know this is another one that I can say that's what she said, but these rum and cokes are going down really easy. So,
cheers.
Cheers. I'm enjoying it. In fact, I think I'm going to polish off this bottle tonight. Robert, Marion loves Charlie. Wait, hold on. Let's do that for the commercial. Oh, sounds lovely. All right, cool. All right. Can't ask my effing question. Chris, at Bottle Cap Barbecue, let's take it down a notch, man. Don't get so angry.
If Mike puts beans or no beans in his chili.
Oh, my God.
He's got a chef. Right.
I'm already fucking tired of that collaboration. I swear.
I was prepared to answer this question. So let me say this. I grew up when my parents made chili, it had beans in it. And so that's the only chili I ever knew until I started traveling. So it kind of seems like it depends on where you're from. But I've had chili without beans and with beans. I love them both. And I can't settle the debate for you tonight, unfortunately.
Mike, I have to agree with you. It's a regional thing. You know, everybody from Texas, of course, everything's bigger in Texas and nobody does everything like Texas, and Texas is the beat all to get all. But in the Midwest, I agree. We grew up with beans in our chili.
Yep.
Why? It stretched it further. That's why. So yeah. Make your fucking chili the way you want. You don't like chili with beans, don't fucking eat it. End of fucking discussion. Rant fucking over.
Amen. Amen, Kent. Thank you.
Yeah, I feel the same way, Ken, with you. I was listening, or not listening, but the Facebook group chat we had, they were going back and forth, using Hormel, don't use Hormel, put beans in there, don't put beans. You all are a bunch of slack-jawed bad people, and you need to man the F up. So I, for one, do not put beans in my chili. But I will be making my chili in a foodie, so click the link below for the foodie Amazon link. Please buy. You don't pay extra, but the channel gets a little bit of cut. Oh, sorry. I've been watching too much of my own YouTube. All right. Go ahead, Kent. Kent? I can't hear you. You're muted. All right, never mind.
All right, I'm back. That's all I had about that shit. I got something for later.
Okay.
You get
you're just pumping in Bottle Cap's question.
Wonder why my blood pressure went up, son of a bitch.
Have another drink. We need to chill out.
Yes, sir.
Kent for president. Nice. better than the. Never mind. Let's see here. Funniest thing that has happened to you while filming that we haven't seen in the outtakes, brother.
Well. If there was something funny, I would have put it in. So nothing funny has really happened. There's been some really aggravating stuff, like we talked about, where you record a whole damn video and realize the mic wasn't on. So stuff like that, you know. So nothing funny yet. And if it ever happens, it'll be in the outtakes. So.
Nice. And hopefully it's not me. And
hopefully it's not done.
Rally Smoke asks why we have to use so many curse words. Apologize if it offends, but sometimes you have to use emphasis when using the curse words. So
I do apologize for that. Sorry.
Damn.
Sometimes people push a right button and that button has no editing.
This is a higher than PG-13 channel on our hot seat. So it's if a bad word needs to be used for emphasis in making a point, It's a lot. All right. Just say daggum. That, Phil, I don't know if that would sound right coming from me. It sounds great coming from someone from the South, but no. Chili can only be made one way. Fuck your feelings. Perfect. Keith Bedtag, of course, said fucking A. And there we go. And that just starts the whole thing. All right, cool. All right. My favorite question. Sometimes people don't want to answer, but damn, no more cussing. Damn. Phil, you could say whatever you want. You're in charge. It's your world. We just live in it, brother. Let's see. If Hollywood were going to make a movie about you, your channel, your girl, your dog, who's playing all you guys?
Leave me out of this.
Leave you out of it.
It's about him.
Well, I'll tell you what. I thought about this one quite a bit, and I'm not sure, but I'll tell you, looking through the comments in my videos these past 6 months, I wrote these down. Somebody said Hugh Bonneville. I don't know if you know who that is.
No.
Don't look him up.
Okay.
There's another guy named Tony Stark.
Oh, so yeah, I can see
people it. People think I look like Tony Stark of cooking. And then someone else said Richard Karn.
Oh, yeah. Tool Time. Yeah. So, Home Improvement.
The guy from Tool Time.
Oh, perfect. That's it. I mean, people, but you guys can put whatever you want in there, but
I'll,
Richard Karn is the winner.
Yep, I agree.
Yep, totally. Used to love that show. I love his new show, the one he has on right now. What is it called? Tim Allen's new show. Kent, what is it?
Don't know.
It's on Channel or Fox.
Don't know.
Lost it. Anyway, I love
it. Last Man Standing or something?
Yeah, Last Man Standing. That's
Last Man Standing.
I've never seen it, but I've never seen the. Is it funny? Is it good?
Someone said, what the? Hobo was thinking Ron Jeremy. Rob D said John Travolta. That's a tough one. That's a conservative show. You're
Elvis.
Right. You're right, Josh and Babe. He is 100% Republican. Daddy Cook says he's digging the Tony Stark goatee. You need to like let it kind of grow to the side a little bit and clear out this part right there, and you'd have it down pat, dude. Yeah, Robert Roy said you do look like the guy from Home Improvement. We agree.
Yeah, so somebody nailed it.
Dante from the movie Clerks. I can see it. Culinary looks like the gopher from Caddyshack. That's fucked up. Elvis Presley. I don't see it. All right, cool. I didn't even hit stop at the hour, but we're over an hour now. It's 15 minutes past. Are you doing all right? You guys still good?
Yeah, doing good.
I'll keep rolling. All right, cool.
Yep.
Because we still have plenty of questions. There's plenty of people in the chat. Someone said Silent Bob. Oh, Daddy Cook, Silent Bob. I like it. That's you need a trench coat. You'll be good to go. All right, so. Are you going to have more live streams in the future? Do you enjoy doing
I'm really glad you brought that up. The one live stream I've done that I'm proud of was that grilled cheese. I had a camera set up. I kind of changed camera angles. But right now I'm taking a break from those so that I can spend some more time working on my thumbnails, my titles, and all that stuff. Setting up the live streams for me is quite a bit of work. Where we're sitting here now, I got to bring up a computer, the camera, the lights, all this stuff, set it up. So I'm not going to do them for a while, but I'll be back. I like doing them. And I just want to make sure that when I'm doing them, I'm delivering some value to people who are watching. So
right on.
I don't want to do it, you know, a half-assed thing.
Some people, you know, Marion's, that's from Robert Roy's channel. That's his niche. He loves doing the lives. I like doing the lives too, but every time I do it, my phone overheats, so I got away from that. The live cooks, and what is actually pretty fun about the live cooks is something could go wrong. You know, something could burn, whatever. You know, it's you gotta kind of roll with the punches, and I think that's a fun time. So. Half-assed is still all she has to offer. Christy's Cooking Channel. Half-assed is all she has to offer. Are you taking a shot? Is it shot time? We taking a
Yeah, it's shot time.
All right. Here's to you. Here's to me. May we never disagree. But if we do, fuck you. Here's to me. Cheers.
Cheers.
You're not supposed to be swearing anymore, CJ.
I was emphasizing my point. Let's see here. James from Emma McClain loves his live feeds. I agree too. I love doing the hot seat. Otherwise, you know, I wouldn't be doing it if I didn't love it. But to actually cook live, that's the hard part. This is just fun, you know, chatting, bullshitting, having a good time. But to cook live, that's a challenge for sure. And Daddy Cook said live cooks require planning and finesse. Anything can happen. It's true. For a live cook, and I think, you know, Marion could probably speak to it too, you need to have everything ready to go and, you know, be just on point with everything or else, you know, something's going to get burned for sure.
Yeah. Marion's the master of it, and he does such a good job. I have a hard time if I'm cooking live interacting,
right,
which is what the live stream is all about, right?
Right.
Developing the community. And he does a really good job at cooking, doing both. So hats off.
I agree completely. Marion seems to, you know, and he'll tell you he's worked at it. You know, it took some time, I'm sure, for him to get it right. But yeah, that's hardcore. Eastman Farm said CJ with an exclamation mark. So yes. See Doncha Freestyle Garage Barbecue. How you doing, brother? I see Cooking with James is here. So we're getting some late runners in here. Very cool. Someone said hi to Rye. Mike, your camera fell asleep again.
Oh.
Time for a beer break.
Caught me sleeping.
Oh, it's all right. There we go. Yeah. Let's see here. I think that's kind of who the people are. James, don't worry, you're late. We got some great guests on tonight. And we're going to be having a lot of conversations. Sorry, CJ, not CJ, met James. All right, fair enough. Cooking with Rye is here. Cooking with Rye, how you doing, brother? Nice to see you. Appreciate you being here. You guys need to check out Cooking with Rye, dude. He does some good stuff on his channel. I love what he does. All right, so my last question, and then we'll go back to Kent. If you guys have questions for Mike, Donna, Kent, whatever, put them in the chat. I missed Tobo's hashtag. So, Ken, if you got it, write it down. We'll say it.
I'll just say it right now.
Okay, go ahead.
It says, "What are him and Donna doing when the screen cuts off?"
It's not that fast.
Yeah.
Not that fast. Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it. That's all right.
Forget about it.
Well, hey, at least we know what's in the box.
That's right.
Every time someone says that, all I want to say is Gwyneth Paltrow's head. All right, bottles
head.
Killed.
You're Italian. It's a horse's head.
What's that?
Damn,
it's a horse's head. If you're Italian, it's a horse's head.
Well, from what, Godfather? But have you seen the movie Seven?
Oh,
of
yeah.
Of course. Of course. Okay, there you go. Gwyneth Paltrow's head.
What's in the box?
What's in the... No! Anyway, all right. So last question, we'll go back to Kent. What's your final goal? What's kept you on the grind? Obviously, you've been doing it for a long time. What's your end game? What are you trying to accomplish with YouTube and this whole thing?
Yeah, I'm not doing this for fun. It'll be fun when I start turning this into a business and the money starts coming in. So right now, you know, the grind for me is getting a format that works, identifying who my audience is, which can be tough to do. But, what I really want to do is go after some brand deals.
Right.
I don't want Kasori to send me something for free. I want them to pay me to show whatever it is they want. So that's my end game, and I know it's a long game, but that's what I'm after. So,
Well, I appreciate the honesty right there. A lot of people don't. A lot of people want that but won't say it. So, yeah. Thanks, Cooking with James, for the $10 super chat. Like I said, never expected, but always appreciate it. CJ and Kent, keep up the good work, or keep it up. Awesome, appreciate it, guy. James, you're awesome, brother. I appreciate it.
Thanks, James.
Cheers, brother. Mike, I'm with you. You know, when I first started this, it was something I wanted to do with my son. You know, because my son's into film production and into high school and all that. He couldn't keep up with what I wanted to do because I want more stuff, and he's a senior in high school, has no time for dad, right? But, and then I started kind of, I used it as an outlet, you know, because I had a rough time. You know, I was going through some personal shit, right? Used it as an outlet, creative outlet, got me away from stuff. Now I'm grinding. Like, I want to make money on this. I would love to get brand deals too. I know Sauce Dash, a lot of his videos are sponsored. And, you know, and he's trying to make a full-time go of it. So anybody will tell you, you're not making money off of AdSense, but the brand deals that come through, all that stuff. Daddy Cook said, work on your format and content, and your audience and prospects will appear, trust me. So obviously, Daddy Cook's Phil's been around for a long time, one of the original creators. Yeah. So you got to take a lot from what he says for sure. I'm with you completely. I would love to make money at this. You know, we got five kids, man. We got a lot of bills paying out. So someday, you know, hopefully, you know, we'll make a little extra cash and pay for the groceries that we spend for the videos, or you know, people keep donating to the camera fund. I would love to get another camera. So that's the type of stuff. I will take whatever money comes and reinvest in the channel. And like Kent, we got him a computer. You know, I want a new camera. We want this to be better. And I think you have the same feeling, right? You want to be better. You want to be a great channel. So
yeah, I just want to push myself as hard as I can, you know, and continually improve. I don't want to get complacent. You watch a lot of channels, they keep putting out the same content and they don't grow. And so you have to, at some point, decide, I gotta step it up somehow. So that's what I'm after.
Right.
It's getting better.
Well, I tell you what, man, you know, I love you, man. You're a good dude. And we've had many conversations and it's great. I'd love to see your channel grow too. And just like Kid, you know, we want Kid to grow, and everybody in the chat too. Daddy Cooks, you know, he finally retires, which, brother, I can't see you retiring, man. If you're still doing your PT test, your gun test, your all that stuff, man, you got it going on, brother. I can't imagine you're gonna retire anytime soon, man. But you know, doing it full time, I mean, I could see this. This is not physically hard to do, right? You know, it's mentally hard. You got to, you know, clean up after yourself, whatever. But you can do this as a retiree. You can do this. This is like a new second job, whatever. But it's not killer. You know, you can improve and get better and all that stuff. So to me, right now, it's a second job. So hopefully someday it'll be a first job, right?
Right.
If
on.
Anyone doesn't want their free stuff, I'll take it like an EBT card. Shane, we'll send you some free shit.
Shane is killing me. I was reading that and laughing my ass off.
You know, Mike, sometimes, you know, obviously you see at the bottom of your screen, you got the three little pictures there. Every once in a while, I'll just look down at Kent and just see him busting up about something. So when I see him bust up, I go straight to the chat to see what he's laughing at. So
I need to work on my poker face, CJ.
Seriously, Cooking with Rye, consistency and commitment. It's true. You know, Smoking Joe's barbecue started when we were 63. I'm with you. Marion said he's running 1.5 miles and can't even touch my toes. I feel your pain. Oh, man, that's funny stuff right there. Well, I appreciate you being honest about what your end goal is here, and I hope that, you know, this little bit of something will help you get there. John McGuire said the same thing. He has a podcast that we see on Facebook, and he's trying to grow it just like Kent and I are trying to grow this. And I love it when we get, you know, sponsors for the hot seat, you know, like Michael Petrie or Dan Wright, whatever. Just right to road. Get, huh? Yeah, the right way. Just to get a couple giveaways, you know, to put in the chat. You know, we're not getting paid to put them on there, or David Parrish with the Slow and Sear. We're not getting paid for it, but the fact that they're giving these items to our fans is awesome. So you know, Delana Burcham, how you doing? Delana, did I say that right? Delana, welcome. Sorry. Cooking with James is not old, and he still can't touch his toes. And James is just like the rest of us. We're old athletes, but boy, I couldn't run to the freaking corner right now if I had to. I don't know about you, Kent, but
well, I live on the corner, so it's easy.
Yeah, I do too, and that's why I can't even run to the corner. Someone, just going back to the cookers that you want to, so someone put in there. You said the pit barrel. A lot of people put the comments on the pit barrel. I have one, and I enjoy using it. I'm no expert by any means, but it does do some good cooking, man. I'm fairly impressed with it for sure. I love it. Eric from Smoking Barbecue and Tips is here. How you doing, Eric? Good to see you. All right. Well, that kind of answers my it answers my questions about your grind and what you're doing and what the end goal is. So hopefully, you know, doing this tonight gets you a couple steps closer, and you know, we'll keep going. Rally Smoke was talking about you could build one a drum smoker for $50. Kent, how much did you build your drum smoker for?
I bought the barrel for $5. I bought the Weber replacement from Walmart, the 22.5-inch grates. I bought three of them. They're $14 a piece. My original one I built for $70. But then I redid it, and I actually took the black iron pipe up the sides with the ball valves to control the air better. Right, just over $100. And I got two cooking grates, and I can cook 16 hours on it. So, mine would be
yourself that way.
Mine would be Chef Johnny. He's not here tonight. I know he's dealing with family issues.
Right.
But he was talking last night in his live. Somebody asked, why do you have the ball valves on the standpipes? And I agree with Johnny 100%. He said, because my fat ass can't bend over all the way to the ground. So that's why they're on standpipes. And that's why I did mine too. I'm 6.5 feet tall. It's a long way down.
All right, Daddy Phil said he built his UDS for $150, but his was sexy. So if you want to spend some money, you get your little sexy, drum smoker.
he has an SDS, sexy drum smoker. Sexy I have a UDS, but I guarantee they cook the same.
Yeah. Eric, no one's criticizing the PVC. I think it's more that you can build an ugly drum smoker for a lot less expense than the PVC, but you know, everybody loves that. I don't know there's anybody that has a problem with the pit barrel, right? I mean, have you seen anybody have a problem with it?
I haven't.
Yeah, okay. So
the drum smokers, I cooked against a guy this year. That's all he does. He cooks on drums. Mm-hmm. He runs them all at 300, and the son of a bitch kicked my ass.
Right.
And they're all the gateway style drums with the standpipes, but all them barrel type smokers are similar. The reason I like the UDS is the size.
Right. Okay. You know? Hobo said something about So I don't know. Hobo has a slight issue or whatever, but Hobo is never shy about saying his feelings. Cooking with Rye said, save the knees. Don't bend down if you don't have to. I think I got the gist of it.
Avoid back problems.
Avoid back problems. Yeah, exactly. All right, cool. All right. Go ahead, Ken.
Okay. I got a couple from Corey for you, Mike. The first one, he wants to know if you have any formal culinary training, or is it are you self-taught, self-taught man-made guy?
Yeah, good question. So the only formal training I ever had, I took a gourmet foods class my senior year of high school, which really got me thinking, you know. And then out of high school, I went and worked in a restaurant, and I became the head cook. I'm not a chef or anything, but I did that for about 5.5, 6 years. And I worked under chefs who taught me a lot, right? So I have that experience. And then this is a long time ago, you know, early 2000s, Food Network. I used to watch that. And now YouTube. So if I want to know anything, I go to YouTube. I've got all of you guys out there that are doing this awesome stuff, and YouTube's where it's at. If you want to learn to cook, I think YouTube is it. So no real formal training other than that.
I can agree with you a lot on the YouTube thing. There's some guys you watch and you're like, what the hell is he doing? And then, you know, you go back, you watch a different video, and it's the same guy's doing it, and it's something you never heard or, you know, learned growing up, whatever. And then you just kind of put the pieces together, and it helps.
Yeah, so. It's like anything with experience, you know. If after you've been cooking long enough, you can watch somebody's video and know that they're not giving you good advice, right?
So yeah, they're either spot on or full of shit.
Yeah, full of shit. You said it. I wasn't going to say it, but yeah, you're right. So I hope that answers the question.
I believe it does. Okay, second one from Corey, and then we're done with his Nebraska ass. he wants to know, when are you going to start signing 8x10s and mailing them out like CJ?
You know, if there's demand for that, you know, then maybe I'll start doing it. So,
well, I'll email you my address. I want to be the first one. CJ's picture is worn out from all the knife throws at it. So,
I'll get you a new one. Don't worry.
Yeah, I bet you will. I want this one framed though, damn it.
All right, fine.
So, all right. Chris at Eastwind wants to know, Mike, have you ever, I know you alluded earlier to the online contest you did for that wine company out in CJ's backyard, but would you ever consider entering like a culinary cooking show? Like BBA or Worst Cooks in America?
No, and I'll tell you why. I think, you know, the reason that Food Network, at least for me, and these other channels really fell out of popularity is they took something that should be enjoyable and like one of the best things you can do for people is cook for them. And they added all this drama and yelling. And I don't think I'd want to be a part of that. I like to cook for people thoughtfully. And I don't know. One of the reasons I left the restaurant business was all of the stress. You know, it's just a crazy, crazy business to be in.
All right, Mike, I don't mean to cut you off, but I see a battery or something flashing on your screen. You want to double check the camera for us real quick? Yep. But
go ahead. I can hear you. I'm just going to swap this out.
Okay. Thanks for catching that, CJ. I appreciate it.
Anytime.
All right.
Real quick, while he's changing the battery, John McGuire, they have a podcast, and I want to plug it because I love watching them. It's called Pit Life Barbecue Podcast. I think, John, correct me if I'm wrong, but it's Pit Life Barbecue is the Facebook group. So jump in there. Oh, Big Joe, dude.
Oh.
Stay lubricated.
If it ain't one Joe, it's the other. I'm
cheers, 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 Big Joe. That's funny shit right there. Oh, man, that's funny. All right, so if any of the mods are in there and sober.
Good luck.
Yeah, throw that link on there. Rally Smoke, Merry Christmas. Sleep well. Have a great Merry Christmas. Hope Santa brings you everything you want and more. So, guys, like I said, check out that podcast. He does live, does it live on Facebook. It's fun to watch. He's got a couple buddies in there. And so do it. Keep it slippery, CJ. At least you're not beeping like my fire alarms. Fair enough. Hobo said no to putting the link in there. Fair enough.
All right.
He's not so over. Back to you.
All right. Mel Simple Cooking. Mike, who was that dancing in the Santa suit in your last video?
Did we lose him?
I'm not sure he's back yet. Mike, talk to us when you can hear us, buddy. Hopefully.
Sorry, guys.
All right, there we got him back.
Yep. Sorry about that.
Thank you, Tom. Kent's Frame Pitcher Fund. There you go. All right. Mel Simple Meals, Mike asked a question. Was that you dancing in the Santa suit in your last video?
I knew that might come up. No, it was either. Not. If I had those kind of moves, I'd be making dancing videos.
All right. So hold on real quick. Daddy Cook says you got to go. Kim needs attention. Stay lubricated, brother. Have fun. Tom's Food Factory dropped a $5 super chat for Kent's frame picture. Appreciate it. And guys, I put the link to the Facebook group for the Pit Life Barbecue. Make sure you guys jump on that one. Really entertaining, really fun. John's smoking a stogie. I've seen it a couple times on there. I wish I could smoke in the house here, but I'm like you, Mike. To set all this up outside would just be a huge pain in the neck. But one of these days, maybe in the summer, I'll do it and have a stogie while we're doing this whole thing. So it'd be a good time. Sorry, Kent. Go ahead.
Okay. Hold on. I had to throw something in there. All right. Sorry. Easy Bake, Jason at Easy Bake Barbecue wants to know, Mike, have you seen anything on the new Blackstone Pro Series and what's your thoughts on it?
Yeah, gotta have it. I haven't seen it available anywhere, but Leprechaun texted me some pictures he saw on Facebook, and that looks like something I gotta have for sure.
Sorry about the dog. I will say it looks, no, hell. At least your dog's just barking. Mine licks a propane tank. Come on now. We'll talk about this in the after show about the
after party
comments. But I saw that today. One of our chats, I think Pickles Barbecue put it in there. The Bob Ross of Barbecue put it in there. Yeah, that thing, I like the way it looks.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. It looks kind of snazzy, for sure.
So I might be double.
Just to have some storage, you know, that you can hide. It just looks good, like you said.
I can see Leprechaun just all puffed out right now. You know, Blackstoners. Whippa!
Wepa.
Kate calls his propane tank. It's your dog. It's okay.
All right, Mike, that's what I got for you right now, my man. Thank God my pen just ran out of ink. Two shows that pen's out of ink.
That sucks. Hey, I thought you'd be happy that we didn't have, you know, three extra shows. Hey, Cooking with Kirby's here. Oh, by the way, Kirby changed his channel name. Cooking with Kirby. He's no longer Kirby's Fishing Grill.
I might have to sub to him. I've never heard of Cooking with Kirby before. I heard he makes a hell of a killer breakfast sandwich, though.
Well, I'm hoping that he's the one sober moderator put in there. So if I need to put a link up, we will. Let's see here. I'll get to it, Hobo. We got plenty of time.
Hold on. I want to address Chris real quick from Eastwind Farms.
All right.
Chris, you need to download the Google Hangouts app, and then you can get on the after show with everybody else if you're quick enough. So
yeah, it fills up pretty quickly. It's a popular after party.
Oh yeah, all the popular kids are here.
All right, cool. You have more questions or no? Hey, Chef's here.
You don't listen.
Not at all.
Hey, Chef, made your the pen and the battery funny. Nice, Rye. Thank you,
Rye. Thanks, Rye. Can't appreciate you.
Chef, made your potato salad tonight for work tomorrow, just so you know.
So, real quick, Chef, condolences. Everybody, you know, that knows Chef, you know, knows what's going on. Appreciate you being here tonight for sure. But we're all thinking of you. So that's it.
CJ, you know, it's not a hangout afterwards unless Chef's there chomping on his ice.
That's true for sure.
Oh,
Hobo, it wasn't my last question. It was like the last question before I go back to Kent. Sorry for the confusion. Go ahead, Kent. Sorry, brother. Are you done again?
Yeah, you missed that. I talk, you don't listen. You're like my wife. You don't fucking listen.
Is this like anything new to you, like at all? Are you surprised?
But Mike made me drink Ruppelmann's tonight, so you know, shit's happening.
Oh man,
good stuff.
hey, Mike. I actually told Mike to drink that at a bar in downtown Cleveland on a live stream he was on. I said, "Go tell the bartender pour you some Ruppelmann's." I introduced him to that.
I did it, and thank you, because that was so smooth and delicious. The problem is it sneaks up on it. You don't feel the burn and all that. So
it's a creeper.
Good stuff.
It's like creeper. Leprechaun TV. It's a creeper. Sorry. Love you, Jay. Got to go.
All right. Cool. All right. You know, one of my questions is who taught you how to cook, but someone already asked that. We can't. What's your favorite thing to cook? Like, what is your go-to that everybody loves and you love cooking?
I think it's steak. Going back to the sous vide thing, I really can cook up. It's hard to screw up sous vide, to be honest with you, but it's the quality of the steak. So I'll get a nice premium Wagyu when I do this. And the cool thing is, when I do it, I don't serve it like everyone sits down and has a dinner. We'll actually put it out on a cutting board and cut it into slices. And everyone just takes a piece while you're drinking. When that one's gone, I'll grab the next one out of the water. We'll put a quick sear on that. Maybe add some lime juice this time or a different kind of seasoning to finish it off. And we'll do that. We might go through four or five steaks in a night where people are just picking at it. And it's such a cool experience. So that's one of my favorite things to do.
Right on. That's a hell of an idea right there. And I'm sure it's very fun to do. That's very cool.
Oh, it's it's kind of a special thing, you know. People aren't used to that, so.
No, not at all. Not at all. Like, that's, dude, that's really awesome. I'm gonna actually give that one a shot. I'm gonna steal that one from you. I think that's, you know, I'll buy, you know, big old steaks and cook them up, but like, you know, half the time not everybody eats them or whatever. So you know, you kind of go as a little bit, and that's a great idea, man. I dig that for sure.
Especially if people are drinking, you know, no one wants to have a big full stomach and then drink on top of it. At least I don't. So
yeah, no, I'm with you.
Honestly, stretch it out.
Yeah, honestly, I don't like drinking while I eat, even like wine and beer and stuff like that.
Yeah,
I'd rather have a glass of water or soda while I eat and then drink late. Yeah. I feel you on that one. That's a great idea. Very cool. Very cool. All right. So, obviously, you're drinking a little Bud Light right now. What's your go-to drink, first of all? And then money's no object. You're going out. You're taking Donna a night out of town. What are you going for?
I'm a gin guy. Oh, I don't know if you guys can see that.
Don't get me started. What's up, brother?
Yeah, now we're talking.
Hey, Hendrix, brother. Look at you.
Got to have the Hendrix. So
right next to the Bombay. Look at you.
Perfect. So I love the Hendrix martini. A little dirty. Couple blue cheese olives. That's kind of my go-to fancy thing. But I'll also do a Hendrix on the rocks with the cucumber.
Yeah.
Slice of cucumber. That's really good. And I'll do a couple of those, and then I switch to beer. So
right on. Yeah, the Hendrix, someone turned me on to it. I went to a fancy schmancy restaurant back in the day, and I usually drink Crown. Obviously, you know, you've seen it on the show and all that, but it was still daylight outside. So I was like, dude, I want something kind of light, whatever. And the guy's like, have you ever tried Hendrix? I'm like, no. Poured it on, got me going on it, did a little Hendrix and tonic, and it was freaking awesome.
So, yeah, it's so good. So good.
Corey said ass kisser. I don't know who's kissing whose ass, but fair enough. You know, I've been called worse in my life for sure. Yeah, so that's very cool. So Hendrix and tonic, daytime drink, man. And then
– Yeah, Hendrix.
I love that stuff. Very cool. Very cool. Right on. All right. I think we're going to put the hashtag shut up dog in there. That's usually hobo. Let's see here. Rye, you totally need to be on the hot seat. I agree. I've tried to get Rye on here, but he's very popular and has a heavy-duty schedule because he's a big-time Hollywood writer. So, Rye, you're welcome anytime, though, brother. Let's see here. Christy's cooking channel, her lifetime question. What's the best and worst thing you've ever cooked? And it doesn't mean on your channel, just at all, overall.
Well, the worst thing I've ever cooked is an easy one. And it seems like something you could not possibly screw up. But I was a young man. It was Thanksgiving. And I had mashed potato duty. And I slightly undercooked them. So I'm going to mash them, and I couldn't get the chunks out. So I had this brilliant idea to use an immersion blender, right, to break up the chunks.
Right, right.
It turned it into glue.
Oh, that starch. Oh, wow.
Yeah, all that starch, yes. It wasn't edible. And so here I ruined it. Everyone loves mashed potatoes and gravy, and it happened, you know, I'm doing this right before they're about to serve turkey and all that. So that was my worst. My best, you know, If Donna were sitting here, I'd let her answer that. But again, I can cook steak, burgers, you know, for my restaurant experience. That's what I cook day in and day out. So, you know, probably a nice high end strip steak or a ribeye is my favorite.
Donna said, if we could only start cooking with Hendrix, we get a sponsorship. You know what? Hey, I love doing the drink videos. You've seen the slushy ones. We doing all that stuff. Do your Hendrix martini. Put Hendrix in the title. Hashtag Hendrix, whatever. And see what it does for you, man. I'm not saying you're going to get a sponsorship. But fuck, you might get some views, you know?
Yeah.
The worst they're going to say is no.
Right.
Right. Right.
Grill Top Experience asked if I consider having one – was it one mod or one like designated mod. No, I give out blue wrenches like they're candy. I really don't care. If you want to be a blue wrench, you can be a blue wrench too. I would love to have a sober blue wrench. You know, Kirby's usually my sober one. The rest of them, I just can't trust. And well, Booger's even got a couple beers in probably when she's on. Let's see, Corona told me no. That's right. Didn't Leprechaun hit up Corona when he was trying to get a sponsorship? Throw it on there. Cooking with Kirby's always sober. Like a designated driver. Yeah, right. And Dan, I don't know if Dan drinks much. He's never gotten a blue wrench. Yeah, Josh, I don't need another drunk one. I'm just saying.
Give it to Babe.
Is there a mauve wrench? I hear Tope's very relaxing. Drink videos are killer. John, I love doing the drink videos, especially I love drinking after the drink videos. But they don't really perform at all. Dan for Smoky Goodness is getting drunk on water. Well, Josh is very offended that I said he'd be drunk. So nice. All right. Anyway. All right, Kent. You got any more, dude?
Yeah, I got a couple. All right, go for it, dude. First of all, suggestion, if you're going to hand out a blue wrench, another one in California, give it to Babe of Josh and Babe.
Oh, yeah.
To Josh.
We're not giving it to Josh.
No. Guy's got enough power in his daily job. He doesn't need more on YouTube.
Exactly. A cop with a blue wrench is just deadly.
Josh doesn't even know how to use a fucking wrench. Sorry, Josh. Love you.
There we go with that language again.
Hey, you've been cussing the whole show. I don't want to hear it. Yeah. Shane in Florida, I'd say give him a blue wrench. Shane's a good dude. But he doesn't get it until after he's on the hot seat.
Fair enough.
All right. Cooking with James. He came in a little late, Mike, so the first part of this question might be a little repetitive. Yeah. He wants to know, have you ever smoked? And if you did you inhale?
So I used to have a couple smokers back in the day, you know. Never could get the hang of it. I know you weren't here, but no, I'm not a smoker, if that's what you're after.
You didn't inhale.
Didn't inhale.
Fair enough. I know you talked about the size of your backyard, and you don't have a lot of room back there. And
right.
So, and I'm pretty sure James missed that earlier. But James, he does have a Blackstone, so you'll be happy for that. And I missed it. It might have been either Hobo or Josh with Josh and Babe, or maybe it was that jerk cooking with Corey in Nebraska. He wanted to know. So with your lousy mashed potatoes that you cooked that turned into starch, did you use them to make paper mache? Or
I used it to hold my fucking house together. It's that stuff was, I'm telling you, man.
That was on your DIY video?
Yeah, DIY plaster, or, you know.
Hey, it's great joint compound for sheetrock, I'm telling you.
Yeah, I'm telling you, man. It was something
else. Don't ask me how I know. I think Leprechaun told me that. So, All right, CJ, you listening to me this time?
Nope.
Okay, then screw you. I'm done. That's all I got.
That's all you got. All right, guys. We're coming up on the 2-hour mark. If you have any more questions, throw them in there. I'm going to ask my last few. We'll stop by Kent just in case, but you know, we're not gonna keep Mike on all night long. All right, three channels you watch, one big, one small, and one you think should be bigger.
Yeah, so probably the biggest channel I watch is Food Wishes.
Okay,
I don't know if you guys watch that guy. Awesome channel, great range of stuff that he cooks. A small channel that I watch that I'm really super impressed with is Smoke and Jazz Barbecue.
Yeah, I agree.
I don't know if you guys saw his video today, but that that pork rack that he did, the rib rack, holy cow. And then someone that I think that should be bigger, and I know he's on his way, and that's Cooking with Rye. So those would be my three answers.
Wow. Cooking with Rye, he's a good 15,000 subscribers. He's doing good things over there for sure. He's an Orange County boy, just like myself. So if we do a SoCal meetup again, we'll definitely be having Rye out there. He's close to us for sure. So I really dig watching Cooking with Rye. I love his live streams on the weekends too. He does some great stuff. So I agree with you on all your choices, and I will allow them. All right. So, all right. If you could cook with anybody in history, alive or dead, who would you cook with? Besides
myself, other than you. This is a tough one. So I'm going to do two, and they'll be quick. Elvis Presley, who's dead, and the guy who's alive, or at least I think he's still alive, is Emeril Lagasse.
Oh yeah.
Huge inspiration to me growing up. You know, he was one of the first cooking shows on TV I would watch. That guy's energy, the way he would captivate the audience, make people laugh. You know, I would love to cook with that dude.
Well, yeah, you're talking about the live cooking in front of a live audience. He pioneered that. Well, I don't know about pioneer, but I mean, he mainstreamed it for anything. He was one of my influential guys too. You know, like I moved out of the house when I was 18. Moving with my buddy, we were 19, 20, and whatever. And we would watch Emeril Lagasse all the time and, you know, try to make whatever he's making and all that stuff. So
the dude was awesome. Sure. Great personality for TV.
Yeah. Mike, how old are you, if you don't mind me asking?
38.
Okay. So you're I'm 42. Kent's just a hair under 40 something or whatever. So
thank you.
You're welcome. So, you know, we're all kind of in the same boat. You know, we grew up around the Food Network as they grew out. So very cool.
I used to get home from school and Emeril would be on while my parents are getting ready to make dinner, you know? So I'm sorry, Mom, if you're watching, but what a disappointment going in the kitchen after watching his show.
Cooking with Rye said he feels old. Keith Bettag said youngsters. You know what, Keith? I don't want to speak for Kent, but I know I have a lot of old war injuries. I feel old. I dye my beard to cover up the really light blonde, as Mrs. CJ likes to say.
It's chrome. So,
I know Kent's hurting in the morning when he rolls out of bed too. Old sufferer. So we feel just as old as you, Keith. And someday, Keith, we are going to make it out to your Labor Day party in Indiana, dude. I'd love to get out there for sure. All right, Keith, Kent, what were you saying, brother?
It's not light blonde. That's chrome.
Chrome. Ooh, I like it. It shines in the light. It's good.
And you're welcome, but, you know, I'm a hell of a lot closer to 50 than I am 40.
Fair enough.
Well, you know.
10
days.
Said, I'm much younger to feel that old. I agree.
10 days, I'm within a year of 50. So,
ooh, yeah. I have your birthday on my calendar. You're not getting a birthday present, but I will mention it. I'll text you.
Good enough. I'm fine with that. It's just another damn day I got to work. So
Cooking with Rye said chrome is character. I love it. That's funny.
Then Rye's a pretty big character.
Yeah, he's
not as big as Chef Johnny.
Chef Johnny is a character. All right, let's see here. All right, we'll ask Meat Cranium's question. Who's on your personal Mount Rushmore? Four people you love, admire, whatever.
Yeah, so I can't do a full four people, but what I'll say is anyone who's been an underdog in their life, who has overcome, you know, crazy stuff and has been successful, is in my books, should be up on that wall. But I'll pick one YouTuber who's been really inspirational to me, and everyone knows who it is, Casey Neistat. If you ever saw his video called Do What You Can't. I mean, that's one of the most inspirational videos I've ever seen in my life. So if you haven't seen it, you should check it out. All right. I'll say those and Casey Neistat.
If anybody wants to pull up Casey Neistat's video he's talking about, throw it in the chat, any of the moderators. John said his body sounds like a haunted house. I agree. Every morning I wake up and 40 different things are cracking. my hands, oh man. I played football for a lot of years. Into college, I played some semi-pro. I played for a long time. And my hands are starting, I've broken every finger on my hands. And every morning it's, whatever. And I think I'm starting to get arthritis. It's great, dude. I'm really old for being 42. This is awesome. All right. Let's see here. Josh and Babe. I'm trying to check out anything in the chat. Kent is not 50 yet. He's still got a little ways to go. What was asking him? All right. What up?
53 weeks. I'll be 50.
All right. Looks like Dan put that link for Casey Neistat in there. So go ahead, guys. Go ahead and click on that. Is Mike buzzing? Are you feeling them beers yet, Mike, and the shots?
I feel good. Feel good. I'll say that.
Yeah, I feel no pain myself. So. It's because every time you took a shot, I was down in the rum. So, what's one thing most people don't know about you?
I think most people don't know I am an avid chess player. I've been playing chess since I was in the sixth or seventh grade. I've got probably 30,000 games that I've played. So I play a lot of chess when I'm not doing YouTube videos. If anyone else here plays chess, look me up on chess.com, American 80, and I'll give you a whooping.
Nice. All right, cool. Any special skills besides being a master chess player?
Just my 9-to-5. I'm a security consultant, really. I'm in sales, but I'm board certified in physical security, so I can do threat vulnerability assessments, that kind of stuff for corporations, and it's kind of my ninja jiu-jitsu 9-to-5.
What kind of schooling did you have to do for that? What did you do in college for that?
So good thing, good question. I went to college for about a year, decided I was smart enough, and dropped out and started working in a kitchen because I was so smart. But through my career, I've had some great opportunities to have certification trainings, and companies pay for that kind of stuff. So basically, for the credentials I have now, you go sit down for a test. You have to have so many years in the industry, and so that's how I got to where I am, in a nutshell.
Right on, fair enough. Yeah, I didn't finish college either. I went to college to play football, not play football to go to college. So once I blew out whatever I blew out, it was time to move on and get in the working world. So I'm with you on that for sure.
Yep.
All right, guys. I'm out of questions. I mean, I have one last question, but we'll come back to that. Kent, you have any more questions? Do they ask any more?
Yeah, I have one from Mel Simple Meals. And Donna, I just read Donna's comment. Yeah, Donna, we're 11 months apart, darling. Mel Simple Bills, what happened with the keto? And what are your thoughts, yeah, Mike? So many people doing different keto cooks and everything like that. Now, she did preface this by saying there's absolutely nothing wrong with keto. So
yeah, great. Awesome. I'm glad you asked that because, first of all, I did keto for about 90 days and I lost about 35 pounds. But along the way, I ended up in the hospital twice. Once, Donna had to call 911. I thought I was having a heart attack. I was in the basement working out. I'm on my keto diet.
Hold on, Mike.
Yeah.
Check your camera, buddy.
Oh.
Shake it around a little bit.
We got the PBS at midnight thing going on.
Yeah, so I'm I don't want to get too deep into this, but I think it's worth saying. So I was working out in the basement. All of a sudden, I get lightheaded, and then these heart palpitations, it wouldn't stop. So I had Donna call 911. Ambulance drove me to the hospital, blah, blah, blah. Everything checked out fine, and it was just this weird thing. They said, well, maybe you had too much caffeine. And so I said, okay, I'll cut out caffeine. A month later, same thing happened, and I went back, and everything checked out fine, right? So it was really weird. So it was a combination of a couple things. Like, they call it the keto flu. So basically, your body is so used to having carbs, like mine was, you start to go into shock or something. But I would just say, be careful. I did it maybe to an extreme. You know, I don't know how many grams of carbs I was having a day, maybe 4. And so for me, it was really scary. And yes, I lost a bunch of weight, but at the same time, I thought I was going to die twice. So just saying, that's my experience. So be careful.
Mike, would you associate, you know, they talk about on some of these survivor shows about protein poisoning, same sort of thing with the keto.
Yeah, same sort of thing. Like,
too much protein.
Yeah, if you're out catching rabbit and that's all you're eating is rabbit, you're going to get protein poisoning. So that could have been it too. But I got off the keto and I've been fine since, but it was really, really scary. So good question.
I tried the keto.
Yeah, me too, but I couldn't leave off the carbs for some reason.
It was the longest 6 fucking hours of my life, I'm telling you.
That's true. All right, you good?
That was my last question. So wrap her up there, boss man.
All right, coolio. All right, guys. I see General Diamond showed up. How you doing, GD? Welcome. I'm going, once we finish up here, I'm going to put the Hangout link to what we're doing here in the chat. So jump on if you want. Get there quick. Otherwise, you might get shut out. So, Mike, stick around after we're off air, okay?
Yep.
Don't click off real quick. Last question that I have, and then we'll wrap it up. Who would you like to see on the hot seat?
Well, I was going to say Cooking with Rye, but then I heard you say that you've offered that up to him. And so, you know, Smoke and Jazz Barbecue if you don't have them.
All right, I'll reach out. I've talked to him a little bit. I haven't offered up yet. I'm just kind of getting to know him, but I like what he's doing for sure. He's a good dude.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Kent, you got any last words, brother?
No, other than Mike, thanks for coming on. It was nice to meet Donna. And, good stuff, man. You're trending the right way. I'll say that.
Thanks, guys. I really appreciate being on the show.
Right. So, again, I'll turn it over to you, Mike, you know, if you want to say something to the people or whatever, and then I'll close it up.
Yeah, thank you, everyone. I'm sorry I didn't have the chat up tonight. I was just trying to stay focused on the interview. But thank you for everyone that tuned in. 2 hours is a long time, so I appreciate your time. And I look forward to seeing all your videos. So thank you.
All right, cool. All right, well, that kind of takes us to the end of our little chat today. Mike, I appreciate you being on. You're an awesome dude, and I echo what Kent was saying. You're trending in the right direction. Hopefully whatever we did tonight will help you get just one step closer to where you want to be. I appreciate your honesty tonight, your candor, and your good stories too. So very cool. Kent, you did an adequate job tonight. I appreciate you too. and all the moderators. Appreciate you guys, everybody in the chat. Thank you for being here. Next week, we have Juan from JP Barbecue is going to be on, and I'm hoping he's going to want to do a little giveaway with his product. I've had the opportunity to try all of his rubs and sauces, and they're excellent. So I'm hoping that he'll do a little giveaway too. So make sure you tune in next week. This is the last show before Christmas, so I'm just going to say Merry Christmas to everybody. We'll be back before New Year's, so we'll say Happy New Year's next week. But I hope you all have a very Merry Christmas. I hope you give everything you want to give to everybody because it is the season of giving. But I hope Santa drops something nice for you too. So, Kent, you got something you want to say, brother?
Yeah, definitely. Hope everybody has a great holiday season. Merry Christmas. When you see them loved ones, give them an extra hug. Lost two very close friends yesterday. So you never know when your time is, so enjoy it while you got it, and Merry Christmas, everybody.
Very, very true, very true. Hug the ones you love. Love the ones you hug. So that's it, guys. I appreciate everybody being here. Till next week, we'll see you soon. Take care. I'm going to put the link in the Hangouts, the link for the Hangouts in the chat after I hit the stop the broadcast. All right. Again, have a very Merry Christmas. Thank you for being here tonight. Take care.